Hi, this is John. Welcome to part 2 of File Server Resource Manager in Microsoft Windows Server 2012. In part 1, we installed FSRM and took a look at configuring disk quotas. In this ittaster video, I'm going to show you how to configure file screens and also take another look at storage reports. File screens block certain file types from being saved to a volume or a folder. File screens do not block users from accessing files that have already been saved. They prevent users from saving specific file types when the file screen is applied. The first thing we need to look at and configure is file groups. File groups enable us to specify the type of files we want to include in our file screen and also specify exceptions. FSRM already has a number of predefined file groups to cover most situations. You can customize them or create your own custom file groups. To create a custom file group, we need to expand File Screening Management, click File Groups, right-click File Groups, and choose Create File Group. We need to give our file group a name. Now, my file group is going to deal with batch files, so I'm simply going to call it Batch Files. And we need to specify the type of files to include. I'm going to use a wildcard of star.bat, and this will include any file with the extension .bat, i.e. batch files, and click Add. We can also exclude files from the group that are exceptions. Let's say, for instance, we want to make an exception that excludes batch files that meet a naming convention with ittaster as part of the file name. We can simply type star ittaster star.bat and click Add. We then need to click OK, and we now have our file group created. To create a file screen, we need to click File Screens, right click File Screens, and choose Create File Screen. We need to browse to the volume or folder that we want to apply the file screen to. I'm going to choose the technical department, and I'm going to define a custom file screen. Click Custom Properties. Now, there are two types of file screen. Active screening will prevent users from saving files. Passive screening will allow users to save files, and this is used for monitoring purposes. We need to select the file groups that we want to block. As you can see, there are a number of predefined file groups, and I'm going to choose Batch Files, the group we created earlier. I would like to receive email notifications, so I'm going to go to the Email Message tab, and I'm going to put a tick next to Send an email to the following administrators. Now, we can also send notifications to the event log, but I'm going to configure email notifications only. Click OK, click Create. I want to save the custom file screen without creating a template. Click OK, and we've successfully created a file screen. So let's put it to the test. I'm going to open up Notepad so I can create a simple batch file. Pop a command in there of ipconfig /all. And I'm going to save it as a batch file. Call it admin.bat. And I'm going to browse to the technical department folder. Click Save, and as you can see, the file screen prevents us from saving the batch file in the technical department folder, and it gives us the option to save the file in a different location. I'm going to choose No and click Cancel for now. If we open our email, we've received a notification, unauthorized file from the batch files file group detected. And if we open it up, it tells us ittaster administrator has attempted to save admin.bat in the E technical department folder on server 1. This file is in the batch files file group, which is not permitted on the server. I'm now going to attempt to save the file again. I'm going to browse to the technical department folder. But this time I'm going to save the file as ittaster admin.bat. Now if you remember, we excluded batch files that meet the ittaster naming convention. That is, files that have the word ittaster in them. If I click save, we're able to save the batch file successfully. If we open up Explorer and browse to our technical department folder, there's our ittaster admin batch file. As you can see, file screens are really useful for managing how users save their data. The next thing I'm going to show you is storage reports. These are really useful. They enable us to monitor disk storage and user data. File Server Resource Manager has a set of built-in reports that we can configure. We can run reports on demand, schedule reports, and you can automatically generate reports as we did in Disk Quota Management. To generate a storage report on demand, we need to click Storage Reports Management, right-click Storage Reports Management, and choose Generate Reports Now. We need to select the report type. I'm going to choose large files, and we can customize the report criteria by clicking Edit Parameters. I'm going to specify a minimum file size of 1 MB, and we can also be selective as to the type of files we want to target. For example, if we're only interested in photos, we can type wildcard.jpg. I'm going to leave this blank and click OK. If we click the Scope tab, we can include all the folders that store these kinds of data. Or we can be more selective and add the volume or folders we want to include in the report by clicking Add. I'm going to browse to our Sales Department folder and click OK. Click OK. I want to wait for reports to be generated and then display them. Click OK. And we're taken to the default report location, See Storage Reports Interactive. And we can open up our large file storage report. And as you can see, it's identified a file called Big Quotes File, and it's 1.67 megabytes. You can also schedule reports and configure FSRM to email them to you. To do this, you need to right-click Storage Reports Management, choose Schedule a New Report task, give your report a name, I'm going to call it ittaster report, and you need to select the reports to generate. I'm going to choose Duplicate Files, and I'm also going to choose Large Files. I'm going to edit the parameters, specify 1 meg, and click OK. Go to the Scope tab, specify the volume or folders to include in the scope by clicking Add. I'm going to choose our storage volume E and click OK. Go to the Delivery tab and put a tick next to Send Reports to the following administrators. Click the Schedule tab. You need to configure the time and frequency of your report. I'm going to go for 8 o'clock and we'll go Monday to Friday and click OK. My report is now scheduled, but I'm going to hurry things up a little by going to my report task, right clicking it and choosing Run Report Task Now. I'm going to wait for reports to be generated and then display them and click OK. We're taken to the default storage reports location and we can open our reports from here. But if we open our email, FSRM has also emailed the reports to us. As you've seen, File Server Resource Manager is an extremely useful tool to help manage data. I hope this video has been helpful. Please subscribe to the ittaster channel. Comments are welcome, and thanks very much for watching.